Welcome to Creative Bath Lab, your channel for DIY bath and body projects. Have you ever wondered what makes Lush's bath bombs so amazing? The secret is they use two different recipes, a slower foaming recipe for the exterior and a more vigorous recipe for the interior. If you're interested in making bath bombs, it's important to know which ingredients cause which reactions. I'm going to show you several different reactions that single ingredients can make. Ingredients that cause vigorous reactions should be put in the interior recipe. This first test has no emulsifiers or surfactants. I just added 1 milliliter each of fragrance oil and witch hazel. This bomb has very loud fizz and was very vigorous and only lasted 2 minutes. And as you can see, this bomb is not that vivacious. This is why I always use a surfactant or an emulsifier with my recipe. This bomb has oil. I chose to use avocado oil, but the results are very similar for any oil. And this bomb was very similar to the first one. As you can see, this one has much better bubbles and foam. It was also quick. As a standard rule, the more vigor a bomb has, the quicker the bomb dissolves. I used sodium alginate, which makes the bombs foam like jelly, and calcium lactate in this one, which enhances the jelly. I was pleasantly surprised at the beautiful, large, and fluffy bubbles this combination made, not to mention the added bonus of jelly foam. I really enjoyed this one. Comparing this bomb to the first one is a great example of how emulsifiers and surfactants act as buffers, which slow down the reactions and also aids in bubbling and foaming. The first bomb had no buffer, so it dissolved so quickly that bubbles were not given a chance. They quickly formed and popped right away due to the high vigor. This bomb is almost identical to the last one as far as reactions go, but it did score slightly higher in fizz and vigor. This bomb is very similar to the last few in reactions, except this is the only one that makes big bubbles that pop right away, but yet is surrounded by thick, fluffy foam. This bomb has unique reactions that no other ingredient makes. This ingredient is a commonly used surfactant. I categorize it as bubbly foamy, and it can be used as such in very small doses, but if used in larger doses, it's definitely more foamy, lathery. The rest of the bombs are slow foaming and are generally used for exterior recipes and bath bombs. They make a lot of foam and lather and last a really long time. They will all have similar major reactions with slightly varying differences. In order to score the beginning part of these bombs, I named the big puffy part foam bomb, and they can vary greatly. Some can be minor and others can be major, puffing up to triple the bomb's size. The slow foaming bombs puff up and produce a high volume of foam in the beginning, but once they stabilize, they become kind of boring for the rest of the duration, which can be a very long time. This is why it's always a good idea to use them in conjunction with a more vigorous recipe in the center. Using both recipes together create a perfectly balanced and very entertaining bath bomb. Thanks for joining me. I genuinely hope that this helps you in your bath bomb making endeavors. And if you're interested in this project, please refer to the description where you'll find helpful tips in the supply list at the bottom. Subscribe now for more creative bath inspiration and stay updated with weekly videos featuring fresh ideas and fun bath projects. Also, connect with me anytime. I've linked my email, Facebook, Instagram, and Pinterest accounts. And if you make any of my projects, I'd love to see pictures. You can post them on my Facebook page where I can interact with you.